Last month we did a teardown of iPhone 14 Pro. Today we will refurbish the screen of iPhone 14 Pro, demonstrating the latest screen refurbishing technology. In the first place, we check if the screen is fully working. Everything looks good. Next, we get the device disassembled. Place the phone screen down on the heating mat at 100 degrees Celsius for 2 minutes. Lift the screen with a specialized phone opener. Then disconnect the flex cables and remove the screen. Now we can start separating the glass. First of all, set the temperature of the separator to 100 degrees Celsius. As the temperature reaches 100 degrees Celsius, place the screen on the separator and turn on the suction button. Carefully detach the sensing module with some alcohol. As the bezel frame of iPhone 14 Pro doesn't cover the screen, we can separate the glass without removing the frame. For iPhone 11 series and older models, the bezel frame needs to be separated beforehand. Keep heating the screen at 100 degrees Celsius. Get an entry point from the bottom corner of the screen. Start separating the OLED along the bottom layer of the glass with cutting wire. After the front glass is removed, clean the OCA adhesive. Apply specialized OCA removing tape to the OLED. Then peel off the tape. It can be seen that the OCA adhesive is almost completely removed by the tape. Through our observation, we found that the touch panel of iPhone 14 Pro is under the polarizer, which makes it less likely to get damaged during refurbishing. For residue OCA adhesive, clear it away with electric glue removing tool and n-hexane. Then we install the OLED for testing. The screen is working fine. Before laminating, we need to clean the OLED again. Tear off the protective film of the OCA adhesive. Since the iPhone 14 Pro aligning mold has not come out yet, we use manual alignment. Align the glass with the OLED. Then stick the screen to the laminator. As the lamination is finished, the screen needs to be debubbled. Take the screen out after about 12 minutes. It can be seen that the laminating and debubbling processes are done perfectly. Next, we install the sensing module in the screen. Turn on the phone. The screen works perfectly. To sum up, the iPhone 14 Pro refurbishment isn't that different from the iPhone 13 Pro. Both models support glass-only repair without separating the bezel frame. Hence the OEM parts of the screen can be reserved as many as possible. The on-cell screen structure also makes the touch resistant to damage during refurbishment. The latest ReFox FM50 laminating and debubbling machine is used this time. In addition to flat screen refurbishing, the ReFox FM50 supports screen refurbishing for tablets up to 12.9-inch or curved screen. If you are interested in this machine, please feel free to contact our account manager. Thank you for watching.